Three, two, one, action. Hello everyone, this is James of the Martial Archive, signing in from the zoo. In the big empty echoey room, so sorry about the poor sound, but this is the only opportunity I have to make a video. So, I want to talk to you today about Japanese shirashi. Some people call them handbills. So this is your standard shirashi. It's A5 size. It has a poster art on one side and some blurb about the film on the other side. There's a release date. There's a website. And they give these out in Japan for free when new films are coming out. Over the years, I've had a bit of a passing interest in shirashi, as they are poster art. And they have been very hard to gain access to. They're in Japan, I am not. I see them for sale on the internet, and a seller will have one or two that I'm interested in, and usually the price is too high, and then you have to add posts on top. And I don't want to pay that much for one or two little shirashi when I can get a full-size poster or something else for less money. So it's always been a bit silly. About 5 years ago, well, more than 5 years ago, maybe 7 or 8 years ago, there were some people in Thailand who started getting shipments of them over from Japan. Some of these people also got Korean handbills shipped over. And they get like a big pile and sell them off one by one. But the prices were still too high. People trying to get 100 baht, 150 baht for one. That still happens today. 150 baht is $5 for one. And it's just too much. So about 4 years ago, maybe 5 years ago, I'm not sure, there was someone online in Thailand who was selling a load, and they were 100 baht each. And I said, look, I'm interested in all of that, because I've only got a few. Everything you have, I probably need. Not interested in Hollywood, but Thai movies, Chinese movies, Korean movies, Japanese movies. I'll buy everything you have, but I'm not paying that much per piece. We've got to work out a better deal. So he came down to 20 baht each, which was much better. And I bought more than 1,000 off of it. I don't know the exact number off the top of my head. I put them into alphabetical order by country. I put them in lever arch files. And it's a pretty nice collection. There's a lot of Japanese films in there that I might never have heard of any other way. There's about 50 I still can't put names to. It's quite difficult sometimes. But anyway, COVID came along, and I had to stop buying due to financial uncertainties. Let's put it that way. So after COVID subsided, this person is still selling. Prices are still high. And I thought about going back to buying from him, well, actually her. But I held off for some reason, and, well, I think still financial uncertainty due to COVID maybe coming back. Now my finances are a bit more certain, thankfully. So a few months ago, there was a new guy selling stuff online, and he was only 10 baht each. So I bought a load from him. I got 190, then I got 200, then I got 300. And there's another person who had two lots of about 70, 80 each, and the price on that was even lower. They were about 5 baht each. There's a lot of stuff in there that I didn't want, but for the ones I did want, it was worthwhile. Unfortunately, some of the last lot in the 300 that I got, some of them I've already got from the other guy, but I didn't realize because I haven't been keeping track.
I'm too busy working.
So, I bought a load of these plastic pockets. I need to get another lever arch file. Sadly, even though this is a school, there aren't any for sale here. And there are other replace it, but I need to go and find one. I need to go and get another lever archetype. And this is my ton of stuff that I need to sort out. So, how are we going to sort them out? This is a long process, and somewhere I have a list of the stuff that's already in the other lever archetypes. Don't know where it is. I think it's on the hard disk from the dead computer. I need to find that disk. I need to use my new gadget and get the data off that disk and find the list. So then I need to sort these out, and then I need to merge. I need to integrate what I already have with the new stuff. And it's a very long and involved process. It can take days. So the first thing to do, to go through, take out the stuff that I don't want from the cheap lots. There's a lot of American and European stuff and grammars, blah. I don't really care. That stuff's all going to be put up for sale at some point when I have time to work on my website again. So don't need those. There's some duplicates. So those need to be weeded out. Then you need to separate them by country. These are Japanese. These are Chinese. These are Korean. These are American. Then you need to take the ones that have English titles, ranging 5, and put those in alphabetical order. Then you need to take the ones that have no English title whatsoever and try and find a clue. So this can be very difficult. Well, for example, we look at this one. It says the word Daiko in English, so you can Google Daiko and see if anything comes up. There isn't a website. There is a release date, 22.7.22. So since there's no website we can look at, there's no other real clues. We know it's released in 2022. We know it's a Japanese film, so then you hit Google. You look for Japanese movie 2022, look at the picture, see if it comes up. Since we have the specific release date, you can Google July 22, see if anything comes up for that. If all of that fails, you throw it in the unknown pile, and you try and remember that it's there. And then one day you'll be strolling around the internet and you'll see something and you'll go, it's that film! And then you pull it out and you go, oh, that's what it's called. So if you do happen to find something useful, maybe there's an English title, maybe there's not. If you can find a Japanese title, you can transliterate that, you can translate it to English with Google Translate, and then you enter it under the translation. So here we go to Google, putting Daiko 2022. Nothing useful comes up. No idea what Daiko is supposed to mean. Seems it might have something to do with like the code of drumming type stuff. I don't know. But the drums are coming up. So Daiko. But the Shirashi didn't like it was anything to do with that. So let's try Japanese film poster 2022. Now you will get more useful stuff come up. You can look through these, sift through, see if it's there. Might take a very long time, might not be there at all. I've seen a few others here that I've got. To put names on later. There's a few websites that have useful information sometimes. You find one good site and go through all the stuff on there. It doesn't seem to be there though. Alright, so we had July 2022 on there. Let's look for Japanese movie release July 2022. And again, I'm not not seeing anything that looks like it's that particular film. So, sometimes life is difficult. I have to go in the unknown pile, sadly, and I just have to continue on, see if it will turn up at some point. So, it's a very long and difficult process, but this is part of what I enjoy doing. I like the puzzle, I like putting the clues together, I like figuring things out. And I do enjoy going down the rabbit hole. There are so many Japanese films that we never get to hear about. For everyone that gets an American or English release, there's dozens that don't. And I learned about so many Japanese films as well. And once you've got the names, you can find out more about them, you can go online, you can find other pictures, you can find trailers, sometimes a whole film on those sites. So it's very good research. So I'm going to get busy with these. And one day I might show you the results. Meanwhile, have a nice day everyone. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. Please look at our website, worldmovieposters.co.uk, and see if there's anything you'd like to add to your own personal collection. Have a nice day everyone. Bye for now.